Let's embark on this journey to explore the biblical truths of availability versus self-centeredness. Friends, how many of you long to live a life of purpose, a life that truly makes a difference? I believe God has placed that desire in each of our hearts. But sometimes we can get caught up in our own wants and needs, letting our own schedules and priorities take center stage. Today, I want us to explore the profound concept of availability from the scriptures. Get ready to discover the joy and fulfillment that comes from living a life marked by availability. When we talk about availability, it's not just about clearing our schedules, although that's definitely a part of it. It's about a heart posture, a willingness to put the needs of others before our own, even when it's inconvenient. We open ourselves up to a life that's richer and more rewarding than we could ever imagine. So let's ask ourselves, are we truly available to God? Are we available to our families, our friends, our communities? Think about the most important, busiest person you can imagine, a president, a king, a world leader. Now, consider God. He holds the entire universe in his hands, orchestrates the intricate dance of galaxies, and knows the number of hairs on your head. And yet, this same awe-inspiring God is always available to us. He invites us to come to him, to pour out our hearts, to seek his guidance. That's the incredible thing about God's love. It's always there, always flowing, always available. All we have to do is open our hearts and receive it. The Bible is filled with examples of availability and the incredible blessings that flow from it. In Philippians chapter 2, verses 20 to 21, Paul talks about Timothy saying, "For I have no one like-minded who will sincerely care for your state." And then we have Isaiah, who when he heard God's call, simply said, "Here am I, send me." Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. Isaiah's availability to God's plan led him to become one of the greatest prophets in history. In Matthew chapter 16, verse 24, Jesus tells us, "If anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me." This love, this selfless concern for others, is at the heart of availability. Overcoming selfishness is a journey, and it starts with recognizing the signs of a heart that's focused on itself. The Bible gives us clear indicators of this: a lack of genuine humility, a resistance to correction, a struggle to confess sin, and a tendency to prioritize personal gain over godly character. But the good news is, God offers us a path to break free from this. It begins with surrendering our pride and embracing humility. When we humble ourselves before God, acknowledging our need for his guidance and correction, we open ourselves up to incredible growth and transformation. 1 John 1:9 assures us, "If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." True availability, true love, cannot exist without genuine forgiveness. Jesus gave us a powerful example of forgiveness when he prayed for those who crucified him, saying, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." Luke 23:34. In the midst of unimaginable pain and suffering, Jesus chose to forgive. So I ask you today, is there someone you need to forgive? Is there a hurt you've been holding on to, a grudge you've been nursing? I encourage you to let it go. Release that person or that situation to God and allow his love to heal your heart. Forgiveness sets you free to love fully and to live a life of true availability. Today, I want to challenge you to embrace the journey of availability. Remember, God doesn't call the qualified, he qualifies the called. Step out in faith, make yourself available to God's plan, and watch as he does amazing things through you. There are people around you right now who are hurting, who are lost, who are searching for hope. Are you ready to answer his call? Are you ready to embrace the incredible adventure of availability? When we shift our focus from ourselves to others, when we embrace a spirit of availability, we open ourselves up to a life of true abundance. We discover the joy of serving, the fulfillment of making a difference, and the deep satisfaction of knowing that we're living a life that honors God. God has a plan for your life, a plan filled with purpose, meaning, and impact. But you have to be willing to say yes to it, be a light in the darkness. be a source of hope and encouragement to those around you. And watch as God uses you to do extraordinary things, all because you chose to make yourself available to Him.